Welcome to Crazy News. My name is Shweta Sinha and now take a look on today's headlines.
Two explosions near airport rock Afghanistan capital as thousands try to flee country after Taliban takeover. Many challenges to open school on September 1st in Telangana. Jharkhand to launch industrial policy today. Dalit Bandhu final trials of rupees 500 crores released. Covid drugs allegation distribution.
Two explosions rocked Kabul, the capital of Afghanistan, on Thursday as the Taliban straightens their measure of access and control of the country.
The first blast was reported at the Abbey Gate, while the second one was near the Baron Hotel, where disparate crowds has gathered seeking to flee the country after the Taliban takeover. According to the reports, as many as 40 people, including children, were killed in the explosion at the Hamid Karzai International Airport. As per details by local reports, a suicide attacker blew himself up in the middle of the large crowd and another attacker started shooting. A latest update informs that ISIS suicide bomber was behind the explosion near Kabul Airport that killed near 40 people and injured several others. The Pentagon had confirmed report of the first explosion from the outside of the Kabul airport. We confirm an explosion outside Kabul airport. Casualties are unclear at this time. We will provide additional details when we can, said John Kirby, assistant to the U.S. Secretary of Defense for Public Affairs. The Hamid Karzai International Airport is the only access point for the international community to reach out the people in Afghanistan. Multiple blasts rock Kabul. Second explosion report near hotel where Americans gather for the evacuation. Multiple blasts rock Kabul. Second explosion reported near hotel where Americans gathered for evacuation.
More than 1 lakh children and adolescents have catched COVID-19 in the state in the first and second wave, according to the data provided by Health Department.
Children in the age group of up to 10 years constituted 2.9% of those between 11 and 20 years of the age, 10.6% of the total cases. Missed or unaccounted cases were put at 5%. The fourth sero survey of ICMR National Institute of Nutrition has shown 55% antibodies in children. There is still worry as the Delta variant of coronavirus is highly transmissible and a vaccine for children is not yet available. Delta sublineages AY12 and AY4 has been detected in 80% of the demo samples sequenced in the state in July.
The Department of Industries, Government of Jharkhand is hosting an investor meet on August 27 and 28 to show off the Jharkhand and Industrial Investments Promotion Policy 2021 to prospective investors.
The event will also seek feedback on the draft of Jharkhand Electric Vehicle Policy 2021 and give a glimpse of the electronic manufacturing cluster to the interested investors. Chief Minister Hemant Soren will be presiding over the meeting at both the days. Senior officials in the state government, including Chief Secretary, Additional Chief Secretary, Department of Revenue, Registration and Land Reforms, and other key officials in the state government will present the strength of Jharkhand to prospective investors and showcase the various industrial policies.
The state government has fulfilled Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao of allocating of Rs. 2,000 crore to implementation the Rs. 10 lakh per family Dalit Bandhu scheme in Huzurabad Assembly constituency as pilot program.
The state government released the final tranche of Rs. 500 crores on Thursday. The CM had promised to extend Rs. 10 lakhs each to all 20,000 Dalit families in Huzurabad constituency under the Dalit Bandhu scheme, for which Rs. 2,000 crore was required. The total amount was released to the Karimnagar district collector in the 5 installments. The first installment of Rs. 500 crores was released on August 9 and Rs. 500 crores on 23 August, Rs. 200 crores on 24 4th August and Rs. 300 crores on August 25. On Thursday, the TS Schedule Cast Cooperative Development Corporation transferred in the final 500 crores to Karimnagar Collector. The Karimnagar District Administration is gearing up for effective implementation of the Dalit Bandhu Scheme.
A court here on Thursday adjourned for over 5 months the hearing in case related to allegedly illegal stocking and distribution of COVID-19 drugs by Gautam Gambhir Foundation and two AAP leaders.
Metropolitan Magistrate Preetu Raj will hear the matter on February 7, 2020. Drug Control Department has filed complaint against the foundation through its CEO Aparajita Singh, Aparajit Seema Gambhir, Gautam Gambhir and Natasha Gambhir for offences under the Drugs and Cosmetics Act. Two separate complaints have also been filed against AAP MLAs Praveen Kumar and Imran Hussain, allegingly the commission of offence. The Act prohibits manufacture, sale and distribution of drugs without a license and make sale and distribution without a valid license punishable with imprisonment for a term not be less than 3 years but which may extend to 5 years within fine.
Amid threats of a third wave looming large over the country, at least 26 students of a boarding school in Mumbai Agripada were found COVID-19 positive on Thursday, sending the authorities into a tizzy.
Among the 26 students of St. Joseph's Boarding School, 4 students were below 12 years of age. These have been admitted to Nair Hospital, officials said. The remaining 22 students who are over 12 years of age have been taken to Richardson Quarantine Center. A total of 95 tests were conducted. The entire area under St. Joseph Boarding School has been sealed by the BMC. Meanwhile, the National Commission of Protection of Child Rights, in response to the RIT inquiry to New Agency PTI, informed that over 720 children in the Child Care Institute in 11 states and union territories have contracted COVID-19 till now and no facilities have been reported. The data from the country's APEC Children Rights Body also stated the 686 children living in the child care institutions. The data from the country's APEC Child Rights Body also stated the 686 children living in child care institutes. CCIs having been affected with the COVID-19 so far this year. Further, the commission data revealed out of 720 children in the such institution who contracted the infection. The highest number was reported from Haryana 288, followed by Tamil Nadu 149 and Bihar 131. No death due to the coronavirus infection has been reported among children residing in CCIs from these 11 states and UTs, the data claim.
US President Joe Biden on Thursday vowed United States will carry out strikes against the group responsible for the bombings that killed dozens of Americans.
To those who carried out this attack, know this. We will not forgive, we will not forget, we will hunt you down and make you pay, Biden said in prepaid remarks for the East Room of the White House. More than 60 people have died in the attack, among them civilians and 13 US military personnel. US will respond with prescience. Joe Biden, the president, further added the US has some reasons to believe the US knows the identities of ISIS leaders who ordered the attacks. We will find a way of our choosing without a large military operations to get them wherever they are. Biden in message said he asked military commanders for plans to strike ISISK, saying the US will respond with precision at a place that we choose and the moment of our choosing.
That's it from me and my team. For more updates, keep watching Crazy News.